Good afternoon, friends. We're glad that you're back with us during this midweek word of encouragement as we look to God's word for instruction and counsel for our lives. And today, I want to talk to you about a group of psalms called the Songs of Ascent. Now, these 15 psalms, Psalm 120 through Psalm 134, it is believed that they were sung by the pilgrims on their way to Jerusalem to celebrate one of the three annual festivals that were required by the law that the nation of Israel would gather together in Jerusalem and honor God and celebrate God's goodness and observe these festivals. It was the celebration of the unleavened bread, or the festival of unleavened bread, which we know as Passover. It was the feast of the harvest, which we know as Pentecost, and the feast of the ingathering, which we know as the feast of the tabernacles. And so, one of the primary themes of this group of psalms was a desire to experience God's protection, to see God as a refuge in the midst of a very hostile world. And as I've looked at these psalms over the last several months, I thought, you know, there are many things in these psalms that are very applicable to our lives today. We're living in a very topsy-turvy and uncertain time. And so I'd like us to look at some of these psalms and see what kind of encouragement we could get for our lives. And today we're going to look at Psalm 121. Let me read it to you. Psalm 121 says, "I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is at your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and your going, both now and forevermore." And the first thing I see in this psalm is this sense of being on a journey. Did you catch that? Did you notice the psalmist talked about his feet slipping? He talked about walking along and looking up onto the hills. He talked about the need for shade and protection from the rays of the sun and the maybe the cool of the night. When he talks about the moon, the coming out and the going in that he talks about towards the end of the psalm. And it's not just a physical journey, which obviously the pilgrims that were singing this psalm originally would be on a physical journey up a path to Jerusalem or up the road to Jerusalem. It's also about going along in a journey that we call life. And so as we journey through life, we discover that we need help. We look for help. We cry out for help. And the psalmist talks about that his help, our help, comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. And we need to understand that this word help means more than assistance. We're not talking about God being our assistant. We're talking about God helping us, that God is carrying us. God's ability is protecting us and shielding us, his ability to save and deliver us from harm. He's acting as our protector, our guardian. I want you to keep hold of that phrase. God is our guardian, because it's throughout this whole psalm, and we're going to talk about it a number of times. So hang on to that thought. And then we're told that God watches over us. In fact, six times in this Psalm 121, the Hebrew word Shamir is used, and it means to guard, to watch, to keep us. And it describes God's action as our guardian. He's not just a casual or passive observer. He's not just standing off to the sidelines and watching our lives go off the rail or something. He's actively involved in our lives. He desires to be an active protector, one who is standing guard, if you will. And as such, he doesn't sleep, nor does he slumber. He's not caught unaware of what's going on around us. The other deities of Israel's neighbors were frequently depicted as sleeping or taking naps, but not the God of Israel. Our God doesn't need naps. He doesn't need to get a good night's rest. He's constantly on guard. He's an ever alert guardian for those who trust him. So as we walk along life's path, as with God as our guardian, he keeps our feet from slipping off the narrow path of life that Jesus describes for us in Matthew chapter 7, when he says, "Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow is the road that leads to life, and only a few find it." The psalmist David declares in Psalm 55, verse 22, "Cast your cares on the Lord. He will sustain you. He will never let the righteous fall." So you see, our guardian, God, is able to keep us on the right path and to keep us from stumbling away from him if we let him, if we trust him, if we turn to him as our help, our protector. God also acts as a shade at our right hand, it says in verse 5. Now, this is more than just protection from sunburn. It signifies protection from danger and harm. You see, a soldier in ancient times would carry his shield on his left arm. That meant his right side was vulnerable to attack. His weak side was his right side. Even though he had a weapon, the shield would have ability to protect him much better from the attacks of his enemy. And so his desire would be that is he would have a good friend, a good ally on his right side to help protect him from the weaknesses and the vulnerability of his right side. And so a way we could look at this is God is our shade on our right hand is that he's protecting our weak side. But we could also look at this concept of shade being as if shade from the sun, because think about it for a second. For something to shade us, it has to be bigger than us. Think about that. I want you to pause and reflect on that for a moment. If God, who is big, is going to shade us and protect us, he's standing on our right side, protecting us from all the heat of the enemy's attacks. He is guarding our weaknesses. He's protecting our vulnerabilities. He's shielding us. He's acting as a shade from the enemy who would seek to destroy us. And finally, our guardian, the maker of heaven and earth, will keep us from all harm. He will watch over our lives, it says in verse 7. And the word life here is more than our physical lives. And we need to grasp that for a moment. It can be translated, it should be translated as our souls. If we put our faith, our trust, our confidence in God, he is able to guard our souls no matter what happens in our journey that we call life. And so while the paths we walk and the lives we live may be fraught with challenges, we are not forced to confront them alone. For we know that there is nothing that can separate us from the love of our guardian, the Almighty God. And so today I want to encourage you to memorize Psalm 121, verses 1 and 2. Let me read it for you again. I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. And in these wacky times we live in, and when things seem to be collapsing all around you, we should quote it and remind ourselves that our guardian is standing watch over us. He doesn't sleep. He doesn't slumber. He will not desert us. He will not fail us. He will guard us. Trust in him, friends. We'll see you next week.